fortunate to attend a two-day face-to-face workshop with Kath Madoc in Mumbai. So that's when, you know, she kind of brought this book into the picture. We were asked to carry this book for the workshop. And we've read different chapters from the book. So the entire workshop that she had planned was based on this particular book, The Power of Inquiry. And definitely, it's an excellent read for inquiry teachers. Whether you are new to inquiry or you've been practicing for many, many years. Like, I have been an inquiry teacher for a decade now. But I still keep going back and forth to this book. It's an excellent resource. And I'm very happy that you've chosen this particular book to read. You know, as soon as I got this message on Facebook, I immediately joined the group. So thanks, Pallavi, for this excellent choice. And, you know, bringing us all together on this common platform to discuss about the power of inquiry. Well, I somehow feel that it's good if you can have a self-read, you know, a pre-read before you come, because the words are very, very powerful. And 40 minutes to read a particular chapter may not be sufficient for all of us. Okay. So if we can, you know, dedicate some time for self-reading. And as you suggested, we can then, you know, meet up on Saturdays or whichever day the group decides and the time. We can all then, you know, further elaborate our thinking and take it forward with the strategies, as you mentioned, which is excellent. I mean, you know, like, what are the things that we felt was worth reading from the book, something that resonated with you. So maybe, you know, you could post some driving or guiding questions to the group each week. And then, you know, in our breakout rooms, we can all further take this discussion. I mean, I feel self-reading might be a better idea to come prepared for the meet rather than, you know, everybody trying to read online together.
Yeah, I'm okay with that. Anybody else?
I do agree with Nadia, because instead of reading here, it will be good if we pre-read and come back and then we can discuss, right? That will help us move.
All right. I think if everybody's okay with that, we can do that. We can show a thumbs up if you're okay with that. And I think, is everybody all right with the meeting being recorded? If you give me the audio-visual permissions, then please show me a thumbs up.
Sure.
Yes.
And for the people who are not put their videos on, I'm taking a yes from them. Okay. So for today, then probably if Nadia, because she has attended, we have a person who has attended a workshop with Kath Murdoch. Nadia, would you like to initiate for today's class, for today's collaboration, anything that we can learn and how we can go about it?
Sure. Pallavi, just wanted to know if you've had a round of welcome and introduction with all the team members. Since I joined in late, I'm not very sure if I've missed something.
No, just greetings. Hi, hello. That's it.
Okay, great. Okay, I think for today, since we haven't read the chapter yet, what we can do is we can just find out, you know, whoever wants to take the lead can kind of tell us with, what you already know about this book, if you have some idea, if you all about the topic inquiry. I mean, not necessary that you have read the book and, you know, whatever your understanding of power of inquiry is, maybe you can share that. Then you can also, you know, tell us about what really excites you about inquiry and what worries you about inquiry. So, you know, if you can take these two or three prompts as a tuning in for today's session, that'll be great. And, you know, also if people can share in, I mean, that's just coming to my mind, that if people are ready to share, how do you think this book club will be worthwhile? I mean, what more can we add on? So if you can, you know, pitch in your suggestions, your ideas as well. So if, you know, how many participants are we on the group?
17. Pallavi,
I'm sorry, I've logged in through my phone, so I can't read too many details. Sorry?
17. Can I make you the host, Nadia? You'll be able to maneuver us better.
That's fine. Thanks, Pallavi. it's just that I can't see everybody on the screen together. I can just see
17
faces at a time. Okay, great. Perfect. So I think let's start with something that, you know, what you think about this particular book or about this inquiry, the power of inquiry. What do you think, you know, is going to be exciting, or what really excites you about inquiry and what worries you? And your ideas for the book club. So anybody
Beedle
who wants
raised
to
raise her hand, Beedle.
Yeah, sure, please.
Bijal, we can't hear you, sorry. Bijal, I'm sorry, can't hear you. Bijal, I'm sorry, can't hear you. Try again. Anybody else who would like to answer these questions, these wonderful guiding questions? And Amita, anything from you? Yes, Kiki.
I just wanted to add that even I attended Katma Talks workshop, which was held in Mumbai in Dhirubhai Ambani School. That was a 2-day long workshop. And it was an amazing experience because of how we look at inquiry and how we being, I've been, an educator for the past 9 years, 10 years, how it changes your perspective every time you go through that presentation or you read this book. You look at inquiry through a different lens altogether. And how you grow as an educator every time you read this book. And you refer back to your questions, to you find your answers in this book, and you really grow and you look, your knowledge increases, and you're always a learner, which builds onto your own inquiry process as an educator. So I think it's a beautiful book for all of us to get together and read, so that we can also get a different perspective from everybody's end. And right now, through the pandemic, the main challenge in our classes, especially in EY classes, the early years, was inquiry. That how to bring about inquiry in when you are restricted to this laptop screen and children on the other end, how do you build curiosity? So I think it's going to be a wonderful sharing experience and how we can, still work when there is hybrid and when there is online classes, how we can still work on inquiry process.
Absolutely. I think I agree to that because I've been teaching E-Curious Mind, my portal. This is this encourages homeschooling. This encourages refresher classes based on IBPYP. That's one thing that I'm really excited about is IBPYP. I have seen the shifts in children because I had been a CBSE teacher for about 14, 15 years. And after that, when I tasted IB, there is no looking back. From nursery till grade 9, I've been teaching this range of children during pandemic. Thanks to pandemic, E-Curious Mind came up. And thanks to that, you all have come in. And I'm learning from everybody. Thank you so much. I felt a lot, it was very challenging for me when I had to, I didn't have place to display. So that display of learning, of that learning journey, of that inquiry cycle became challenging for me from home. Very, very challenging for me. My children used to learn when I used to put up their work and reflections used to go on the board. So that was one part which I found very challenging. The second part I found very challenging was to with those questions, to hold their attention, to sway them through that inquiry cycle. And because it's not linear, so anything and everything, I felt I was lost. And through this book club, I'm hoping to learn more from everybody. I'm hoping that after this book, we go to another inquiry book. And I'm looking forward for more collaboration, more learning. That's it from my side.
So if nobody's... Oh, Priya, you want to go first? Go, please go. It's okay.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks, Purva. Thanks, Pallavi. I think it's a great initiative that you've taken. And it's great to be a participant and a collaborator here. Like we all know, the pandemic has gotten us at home. And of course, it has given us new opportunities also. I think we all are being explorers at, exploring different tech tools. So I myself am a PYP educator. I'm working with the Oberoi International School, Mumbai. And most of y'all, I have attended the inquiry workshop too, which was there. I think some things which I have picked up besides the book was, as a teacher, every teacher wants, every educator wants her or his learning environment to be full of purpose and passion. And I think that's what Kat Murdock is really all about. I mean, when I was attending this workshop, I was really naive to why she's known as Guru. I mean, I knew that she's the inquiry, the tuning in the cycle. It's her baby and stuff like that. But I was really not still convinced that why Guru? What's the reason? But when I actually attended her workshop, it made me think, you know, that there is a reason why we want the students to wonder. There is a reason why we talk only about curiosity, only about, you know, the sparkling minds, because that's what actually leads an inquiry forward. When you sit and, you know, when you sit with a student and when you start questioning the child, the student, all you are doing is helping him dig deeper and deeper into his inquiry. And the same thing can be reinforced towards the student. I mean, there was a phase initially where I was questioning the children. And this is the condition, you know, I observed in an online forum for myself, that now I have enhanced that the students are asking this. So I think all the, you know, educators, learners, this is what we all are getting into with IB. And I think that's what the power of inquiry does. It helps you to build your own skills to move ahead. So yeah, that's what I think we all are here for. We are collaborating through the power of inquiry again. So yeah, thank you.
Purva, you wanted to say something?
Oh, I completely liking this whole setup, you know. So thank you, Pallavi, for this platform, first of all. All right. And I don't know about the book, but yes, I do know. I don't claim that I know inquiry, but yes, I have been practicing some of the stuff from inquiry. So when Priya said that it is more about the passion and the purpose, so and I can actually connect with passion and that online learning, virtual learning environment. So I think that when we look from the perspective of students, okay, when we talk about, okay, inquiry and questions and questions. So the why part of question, for example, if I say, we have to ask questions. I was reading a book, Ask Art of Questioning. So how to ask questions? That is again a big chunk where I still fall that I cannot convince students, learners, you know, that everybody has to ask. So there again is a stage, okay, one step. So let's ask questions. So yes, there was a phase in my class also where I used to throw a lot of questions like that, this teacher's question, and then they had to come up with big and small questions and thick and thin questions. So all I wanted to say is, like, if we are not able to ask ourselves as educators that am I making that child thinking, am I making that child wondering about the surroundings, we are not inquiring into anything. If we are making that happen, yes, we are somewhere in the place, and from there we can start our journey. So that is what inquiry means to me. I may be wrong, but that is what my understanding so far. And I am influenced by the other author, Jo Bowler, as well. So she also is a fantastic writer, fantastic author. So I would like you to, you know, after we finish this, can we take that book? Because she has also got very good and provoking some books and some questions, because Limitless Mind is a book I really liked about it. And then there is U cubed, and there is Math Provocation. So all is connected, you know. It's not ending here. It's just the starting point. And I'm so fortunate that this virtual platform actually connected us. So right, some suggestions I have for the reading club, as Nadia was asking. So I attended one webinar some days back. It was held by Neve Academy. That's a SIPSA. Everybody must be knowing about it. So there I got an opportunity to work with other educators, and there also we worked for the book club. So what we did is we created a Word document, and we fed all the details of ourselves, and we decided on one book. And then, for example, the book is a big book, a thick book. So we ourselves decide, okay, from page number so and so, I'm taking a responsibility to read. And then questions, wonderings, your big ideas, you are responsible to discuss it in a big group or in a breakout room. So that way it is easy to complete a big book like this in short span of time, and the purpose is also solved. And we are having an opportunity where we can discuss more and more and more. So you have this chunk, you are responsible, and that is your baby for that time. So yes, we pre-record ourselves, yes, there is one more option I have been discovering. So now, because Zoom is a good thing, so you can share your screen, read about, and take the recording, and you can insert that recording later, so that if somebody wants to listen, somebody can be an audio learner like me, so they can actually listen to the book instead of reading. So all these implementations we can play around when we are in a book club. That is, I think, what we are looking forward to.
Thank you, Purva. I think that these are very, very, very good suggestions. And of course, there is nothing right and nothing wrong.
Exactly.
Pallavi, am I audible?
I'll just join in, ma'am, for a second. I mean, I don't know how long I can stay for this webinar. I just wanted to say a few words. Can I, ma'am?
Please, Priya, please carry on.
Yeah, hi everyone. I was just wanting to share that I really worship and I have read in detail the other book I have of Catherine Rock, and it says the tuning in part for my early years children has been so wonderful. And though I have not been in this field like you all for like the
Priya, you're on mute.
Yeah. See, think, and wonder. That is my focus in the beginning of any central idea that I'm going to start, any UI that I'm going to start. I believe that see, think, of they have to observe, think, and wonder. And when that is a successful part, then I'm very, very happy with the tuning in of the new central idea. So that should be that has always been my focus with the early years. And the amount of prior knowledge that these toddlers share is just amazing. You know, you all must be thinking, how can I be benefit the early years? When we have our PTM, our parents are only asking, what is IB? How is it going to benefit the early years? And I say, you won't till 8 years, the amount of prior knowledge that they have, even we sometimes don't have. You know, so many times I'm sharing something with you, I may not share my prior knowledge because I have so much, other things on my mind. But the early year learners, when they see something and when I decorate my class for the new unit, they immediately, the first day itself, the number of questions they come, they have observed it within half an hour, they will ask me questions. And my tuning in is so successful. That is what I believe. If your tuning in is successful with your new unit, the whole unit will be successful.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for sharing, Priya. That's really nice. And absolutely right. Tuning is very, very important. So here the content page says
Pallavi,
that there are...
Am I audible now, Pallavi? Hello. Yeah. Am I audible now?
Yes, Bija.
Hi. First of all, I'm glad to be a part of this group because, as I mentioned, I do follow Kate Modak. I enjoy Inquiry Cycle. I've gone through her books also. And the best part is I really enjoy, referring to her learning engagements where she has shared with all the, with the entire Inquiry Cycle. And I do add in my, I do have my own inputs for the same, and it works wonders. And being a part of this book session is really going to, it's going to be a great idea. As Nadia said, we're going to have a good learning and sharing throughout the group. So that's going to be really nice.
And yeah, inquiry is really a kind which really interests children. It is usually, if it is of interest to children, it also engages them on a higher level, making learning more informative and engaging. Same goes with us, I guess, if when we are doing this together, it's going to be a good journey throughout the book. So looking forward to it, and thank you so much for, you know, forming this group. It's a pleasure to be a part of it. So thanks again.
Thank you so much, Bijal. Now quickly, we have on 10 chapters we have from page, the first chapter talks about a fresh look. So who wants to pick up the first chapter, Nadia? Would you like to initiate or the teachers who have already attended CATS workshop? The first few chapters, if you want to take up.
Do you want somebody to lead the chapter, like what I think one of the participants mentioned? Or should we all read and then come back in our breakout rooms and discuss about what really resonated with you and discuss about the chapter? What do you think?
I think reading and coming back would be better. This is what I feel. When we read and we get back together, I feel that would be more yes. feasible. Everyone can read at their own span of time and share. That's what I think.
I agree.
That's my perspective.
Even I agree to it, that everybody reads in their time and then we come out and share our understanding and then look out for the best practices that we can follow for that.
Right. I would also suggest, Pallavi, that we can have a Padlet or a Wakelet and, you know, whichever quote or, you know, a particular idea that you really like and you want to pick and discuss, you can add it on the Padlet, and all of us can also collaborate on Padlet, because, you know, say about 40 minutes or an hour session may not give us enough time to discuss each aspect of the chapter. So we can even create a Padlet link or a Wakelet, whatever suits us. And then, you know, we can keep posting, writing down what really stuck with me or some idea that you really liked from the chapter. And then we can even collaborate on the Padlet. So that can also be done.
Great. Anybody who wants to start the Padlet, let's all collaborate and
I can open one. I can do that today. Yeah, I'll do so.
Thank you, Nadia. I'll also make you the admin on that WhatsApp group. It will become easier.
Sure.
All right. So we do that. Then, of course, we're going to sit and reflect on what we have learned. That's how we're going to close whatever new things that we have learned and what do we look forward for in the next class. Now let's discuss. Do we want it on the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, or can we also have a weekday in the evening? What is more comfortable?
Can we just keep it to Saturday, because I'm committed to other book clubs too. Right.
No problem. How many of you are comfortable with Saturdays? Most of them. Okay. Same time, 2:00? Or do you want to keep it early morning so that you're free for the entire day?
I guess the afternoon time would be better. If we have school and all, then maybe if everyone's okay with it.
I guess this time should work better for all of us, the 2:00 time.
So that means it will approximately take us, if we plan, but I think it will take us about 11 or 12 Saturdays with 3 months to complete a book.
If you take one chapter each week, then you will be able to finish it in 10 weeks.
Okay.
Or you can take 2 chapters, but that won't give you enough time to discuss every bit of it.
We don't want to rush through it.
Let's keep it to one chapter per week.
So everybody, when we collaborate again on Saturday, next Saturday, 2:00, so we read the first chapter, we come, and however way that you feel is the best way that you can share your understanding. Of course, Nadia is going to create a Padlet also, but you're open to share your ideas, you're open to share your understanding either through PPT or just discussion. It's your choice. It's completely your choice how you want to do it. And that 1 hour, we will learn and we'll come up with the best sharing of best practices as well. And of course, the most difficult part that we face, wherever we get stuck, we're going to bring it on the platform. Okay. Anything else that you think we can start with or this is
Pallavi, there were others in the group who haven't had a turn to speak, so if we can allow them to speak now.
Of course, please carry on. Kritika, I'm sorry, I'm not able to get your name. Kritika, would you like to speak? Arun, Emma, Harsha, Sheetal, Jeenal, you haven't spoken though you created the whole. Thank you, Jeenal.
Pallavi, my pleasure. So I don't know, do you want to make any essential agreement as we start, you know, the basics of PYP? So it will be really nice. And so one essential agreement from my end is we will not call anyone on this group ma'am, miss or anything. We'll call them by their names. Because that's one thing.
A double thumbs up from my side. Yes, please.
Yeah, so that one thing I would, you know, being a PYP teacher and educator, so that's one thing that we start our class or start our session with. So that's the thing. So I have not read the book. I have heard a lot because I'm not a reader kind of a thing. And this book club would actually help me to, you know, read that book and be on toes. So the reason to join this is that only because it's been on my mind since long. And so thank you, Pallavi, you know, for this initiative. And, you know, I can just, I think rather we can just read that book and have a better understanding about inquiry and the approach. And of course, the goddess of inquiry, that what is the motto behind, you know, inquiry. So that's it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Gina. Mary, hi, you've just joined in.
Hi everyone.
Hi,
good
Mary.
Afternoon.
Good afternoon, Mary. We were talking about how we can take the program forward, how we can collaborate online, how we can read.
Yeah.
May I know, Mary? Where are you from?
Yeah, I'm from Andhra Pradesh, Guntur.
Welcome, Mary. Next Saturday, 2:00, we all come back with our own understanding of chapter one. We're going to self-read the chapter. Nadia is going to create a Padlet. That Padlet, she'll share it on the WhatsApp group. And whatever you think that you have learned, or what the things that you've got stuck, the things that you, you've learned, the things that you would like to share, you're most welcome to put it on the Padlet and then we can discuss. So this meeting was actually to tune into reading and to see how we will unwrap the whole book. I'm really excited for this. Really, really excited. I haven't read the book. I always go on YouTube. I always go on Google and read tidbits about it. But I've been looking forward. I can't read alone. That's my problem. So that is the reason I was looking for you all to come in and to help me read the book. Thank you. Thank you, everybody, for coming in. It means a lot to me.
Okay. Hi, Pallavi. Would like to speak.
Yes. After Harsha, Amita. You were also trying to speak.
Yeah. Hi, this is Harsha Gandhi. I'm from Mumbai. And Pallavi, thank you so much for this group. I would say a great thanks to Ms. Jeenal. She just quickly sent me the link. I did join in a bit late. And as I was in my Saturday group, I would say, and yes, when you talk about reading becomes a little more challenging.
Harsha, you're on mute.
Harsha, you went on mute.
Yeah, all right, can you see? When you mention about reading becomes a little more challenging when you have something very interesting to read about. And you need friends. Of course, we need friends. So as Ms. Jeenal said, that let's not address everyone as Miss or, you know, a teacher. Let's just be a little more candid. And yes, of course, from one essential agreement from my end, that let's not be judgmental because everybody's knowledge is different. And none of us are Einsteins. So let's really not be judgmental and let's pull up and supportive to every learning community that we have here. So that's from my end. And Yes, of course, the lit circle, we can have the lit circle when you say reading together, you know, we can just have the breakout rooms. I think that should be interesting. And I would be very open enough that I am not, I have not read the book, and I have just seen the videos of Katmadog and learned from there. So it would be great if somebody would just share the book link.
Pallavi, you're on mute.
Harsha, log in to the WhatsApp group. I'll share the book with you. I have the PDF of the book.
Yeah, I'm already there.
I'll share the PDF. Don't worry.
Thank you so much. Thanks a lot, Pallavi, for this platform.
Thank you.
Yeah, so even I have not read the book. Yeah, I've been a PYP facilitator for the past 4 years, but not read the book. Following the inquiry cycle, according to my understanding, according to listening to others and following it. But yes, when I got an opportunity that we are going to read this book together and come up with our ideas and share ideas, I just jumped to it. I said, no, I will have to be a part of this group, because it was there in the back of my mind that I have to read the book. I have to read the book. But you know, if you get some book which is imaginary, when you get this type of book, you need some enthusiasm, motivation to, you know, read it. Apart from the books, like, you know, the other novels or something which you want to read it. But when you want to read such books, you really need motivation. And thank you, Pallavi, for coming up with this platform. And hope to share an experience. Hope to have a good experience and good collaborative session here.
Thank you so much. Yes, we all are intending the same thing. Please, if anybody else, Emma, would you like to share something? Emma?
Hello. Can you hear me?
Hi, Emma.
Hi, sorry. I was in the nail salon where I am. It's like 5 o'clock at night. So I was listening. I was like, come on, lady, come on, quickly. Thank you for all your contributions. I also arrived late. I only saw this message about 20 minutes before the call started. I think it's really nice that we can connect with people all around the world. Currently, I'm a New Zealander and I'm teaching in China. I've also worked in the Middle East. And yeah, I have a little bit of an inquiry background from the New Zealand curriculum, but I too have just read maybe 3 chapters of the Kath Murdoch book. I know the book is difficult to get hold of, but one of the things I've wondered is if we really should be sharing the PDF of the book around, just because of copyright. You know, like that's, yeah. I know I had to wait like 6 months, 8 months to get the book here. But yeah, that was just something like if we're in a forum, like a worldwide forum, I just wondered about that. Yeah, otherwise it would be really nice to be able to collaborate and discuss and talk about how we deal with these things in our classrooms.
Thank you. Thank you, Emma, for sharing. We're looking forward for your understanding on this platform of the book. Okay. Arun, would you like to share something?
Hey, hi, Pallavi. Yeah. So myself, Arun, like I'm from southern part of, like I'm from Tamil Nadu. I run a school. Basically, I'm an IT guy. Last 3 years, I'm running my own school, and I got exposure to PYP in this COVID time. I wanted to do something, some kind of transformation in my school. That is how I got exposure to IBPYP. And then we are learning about it. In this group, like already I know Harsha Gandhi, like already I had a lot of lengthy conversation with Harsha, and she's helping me to get up to the standard in a PYP area. So beyond that, like I have very very limited knowledge about inquiry, and I'm happy to be part of the team, and I will try to contribute more.
Thank you, Arun. Yes, we all have limited knowledge in our own way. I always feel that we are a community which is a jigsaw puzzle, where we feel that we are an important part, but when we come together, we form a big picture.
Yeah, I agree with you, Pallavi. It's really a great initiative. Thank you so much for doing this. And I'm sure like when we complete this book, we will be completely more and more knowledgeable from where we are today.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Arun. Sheetal? Yeah. Tasneem?
Hello, hi.
Hi, Sheetal.
I'm Sheetal. Hi. I would like to thank you, Pallavi. You do me this opportunity for book reading session. Actually, I'm a new in that curriculum. Actually, my last 17 years experience is in CBSC also. But last year, I was joining, last 2 years, I was joining Okhad Global School, and last year I have taken a classes. That's why that is all of new for me. And I would like to learn that new things and inquiries cycle and all these things.
Sure. Welcome, Sheetal. Thank you. Thank you for sharing. Tasneem?
Hello, everyone. I'm Tasneem from Egypt. I have 2 years experience in the IB and I'm homeroom teacher for PYP 8. I'm really so glad to be here with you. I can't thank you enough for this opportunity. And I think, inshallah, I'm going to do my best to share all of my experience and learn, of course, from all of you.
You're looking forward for the same, Tasneem. Thank you for joining in. Kritika.
Thank you so much for this opportunity.
Thank you. Kritika. Kritika, can you hear me? Okay. So if there's anybody else who would like to share? Okay. So next Saturday, 2:00, we come back with the first chapter, our understanding, our best practices, and the areas we feel that we need to work upon. Gina, would you also create the meeting for the next Saturday?
Yes. Can I keep it recurring so we log in?
When are we going to meet? When are we going to meet?
Next Saturday, same time. Third of March.
April.
Sorry, 3rd of April, right. 3rd April, Indian Standard Time, 2:00. All right, then I think we wrapped up quite before time. And I'm hoping to see all of you and more people next Saturday. Nadia, would you like to say something?
No, I'll quickly share the Padlet link with all of you all on the WhatsApp group. And so then we can all start reading. So happy reading, everybody. And see you next weekend. Have a great week till then. Bye.
Thank you.
Have a good closing. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Thanks.